Champlain, a serene freshwater lake in northern New England that covers more than 400 square miles.
The sightings of a watery monster in upstate New York's Lake Champlain have gone on for decades.
It's lived in local folklore for generations.
Get away from the water!
I'm like, oh my God. And then it picked its head up and came up.
History supports the possibility an unknown creature lurks in Lake Champlain.
It's not inconceivable we could have an ocean migrant who got hopelessly lost.
And now, new exclusive video, obtained by ABC News, of something just under the surface, has brought Champ back into the news and back from the memory of Lake Champlain residents.
Challenging old evidence as others search for proof.
The only thing really missing is the body.
See anything.
Huh, looks like it's Joel to the rescue.
Ew. Creep. Whoa!
We're closed! Can't you read the sign?
Sign says open, love.
Perhaps you should read it with your one good eye.
Don't you sass me, you young whippersnapper!
Are you like the owner of this store?
I wouldn't own this place if the last store in town belongs to my sister Earlene. I'm just keeping an eye on it while she's away.
Does she live nearby? Is there any way we might all reach her?
She went to the big city to have some cosmetic top surgery done. She had a mole on her face, grew so big, practically the size of a baby's field mouse. is the ugliest thing you ever did see. Now get out of here. Get off here.
Oh, well, what the hell was that?
I just want to get the hell out of here.
Jesus Christ, you scared me.
Y'all lost or something?
Gee, what was your first clue, Sherlock?
Mallory.
Yes, sir. Actually, we were on our way out to the lake house, and we seemed to have veered off course a bit. We stopped by the store to buy a few things, but they don't seem to be open.
Well, Erlene, she runs a store. Had a medical emergency. She had to go down to one of them city doctors, have a mole cut off the side of her face. It's about the size of a kangaroo mouse. Anyway, she'll be back in tomorrow. You can go to the store then. Now, you're looking for the lake house. You go back down this road about 3 or 4 miles. Make a left-hand turn. You run right into it.
Thank you, sir.
All right, get on now.
Hate mosquitoes. The thing this area has is a boatload of mosquitoes.
I believe they're called Cochinella septemticata.
I believe you might want to repeat that in English. Here you go, Joel.
Well, perhaps that's what they call them where you're from. But, down in Mexico, we call them mosquitoes. And, down there, we got mosquitoes so big they could stand on their hind legs and make a sweet love to a cockroach.
Well, would you look at the time? Oh, if you'll excuse me, I'm going to need to get an early start if you want to test run on the aquatic software.
I don't blame you.
Yes, get your beauty sleep, my lovely.
All right, Joel, I'm turning too. How about you?
No, I'm going to test the night vision on the camera. It shouldn't take me too long.
All right, then. I'll see you in the morning.
I think I might have left something up in the cabin. Hey, hold on, where'd you go?
Hello, love.
Such a jerk.
Hey, you're looking a little hot up there. Why don't you come in the nice cold waters and cool off with Joel? Excuse me.
Dude, turn that off. It's killing the reception.
No, I was just out there on that lake. I was getting great footage. I was told to come in here. I don't know why I'm even in here right now. I need my popcorn to live. I haven't eaten any breakfast. We haven't even been to the store yet. Why are you breaking my balls right now?
We've got to get to the store today because I can't keep living off beer and popcorn.
Who doesn't like beer and popcorn or watching TV for crying out loud? We're about to... Disgusting. Germs everywhere in this house. I can't live like
this. All right, enough. Kids, let's go.
Well, you kid, you. All right, fine. Let's go to the store. Let's get some real food. Let's do what you want to do.
Yeah, let's just do
what you want to do. I'm only making genius
tea. Shut up, Joel. Let's go.
You know something? You will appreciate this tea. I swear to God. I might even be on sweating blood. Is this part of my per diem?
Gonna have to see some ID for the chew, my son.
It's chewing gum.
Federal regulations and all. You know, I know it's a pain in the ass. I've been chewing my whole life. It ain't done nothing to me. That's the way it goes. $57.33.
It's chewing gum.
Don't you back talk to me? Your fancy French accent. We don't tolerate no foreigners around here.
It's chewing gum.
$57.33.
Got me an APB on that mass murderer that's roaming the lake. Now we got a serious situation out here, girl. Come back.
Sorry, Sheriff. You say you needed some apples and peas?
Jesus, you are the dumbest individual I have ever met.
Now listen, Sheriff. You're gonna have to slow down here a little bit. I can barely hear you. Come back. Sheriff, the phone's ringing now. Hello? Who? I think you got the wrong number. Oh, Bob? That's who you're looking for? Well, he didn't show up to work yesterday, and I told him if you didn't come to work yesterday, don't bother coming today. That's right. Now listen, Sheriff. You're gonna have to slow down. I can barely hear you.
I'd say we pull over to this establishment right here and try to hang some flies.
What are you talking like that for?
Well, I think we should use different accents so these people don't know who we are. I think these freaks of nature are going to get all pissed off, come at our cabin with torches and pickaxes, try to cut off more beautiful schnauzers and make long bacon out of it.
Shut up!
Oh, boys, looks like we got some company coming in. Get ready for him. Now be polite.
Hi, good morning. I'm Lori. I'm here with my film crew.
Y'all need haircuts? It's gonna be a few. We're kind of busy right now.
No, no haircuts today. We're doing a documentary on the existence, or like the non-existence, of the Lake Champlain
Monster. We're even offering a reward. $100 for the proof that the Lake Champlain Monster exists.
What kind of proof y'all need?
Just like a photo or video, even a sound recording, but it needs to be clear enough to examine and preferably something recent.
Preferably something other than old footage of a floating log or Jimbo's dog out for a swim.
Yeah, that damn mutt. I told Jimbo to keep that dog in his own yard. Somebody's gonna shoot it.
$100 reward if anybody's seen it.
Don't need to go alone, Zane. Need to need ya. All you need. Get the monaco.
I noticed you have an accent. I have an accent too. Perhaps we can get together one day and discuss the ways of our people.
Have not day, jiggle day, don't tell y'all today.
The great chief says, many moons ago during the spring of the red sky, the white men came to these hills. They disrupted the peace amongst the people and jeopardized their relationship with the monster of the lake. The white man's mining and construction of the bridge drove the great beast deeper into the waters. One day, when the season of the red sky has returned, the monster will reclaim the waters and destroy the white devils. Then, peace will be restored.
All right, well, number's on the poster, so if you change your mind, feel free to give us a call.
Will do. Thanks for stopping in. You know, you might want to try talking to old Jimbo Perkins. Lives about a quarter mile up the lake. Sits up on a hill. Sees everything up there. If there's anything to be talked about, he's the one.
All right, well, appreciate it. Thank you.
Chunks, Greg. I didn't know you could speak Indian.
You didn't ever ask me before.
What can I do for you?
Hi, yes. We're here in town making a documentary, Champ, about the Lake Champlain Monster. We just want to know if maybe we can have a minute of your time to talk to you, see if you've got any stories or anything.
Get back here, you sorry ass! Damn dog won't stay still a minute. I build a fence, it digs a hole. It doesn't dig a hole, it's shitting mud pies and heaping piles of shit all over my lawn.
Right. Well, maybe if we could have a minute of your time to sit down, ask you a couple questions, see about your opinion on the Lake Champlain Monster.
Damn
it,
Jimbo, I told you not to let that dog over here. It's shitting mud pies all over my yard. You might try talking to the town superintendent. Lord knows he ain't camera shy. I don't think you're gonna have any luck getting other people wanting to be interviewed after the incident. Well, the incident and all.
You mean with the Lake Monster?
Damn it! I told you this last time! Stop shitting in my yard! Damn it, Jimbo! I'm
Come on in.
Mallory.
Hi, how are you?
Hi, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. So, you're out here doing some research for a movie?
Yes, sir, we are. We're here doing a documentary on the Lake Champlain Monster, and we're even offering a really nice reward, but so far we haven't had any luck getting any of your town folks to talk to us.
Well, that doesn't surprise me that people around here are reluctant to go on camera after the incident.
Incident?
You wouldn't happen to know about what went on here a few years ago, would you?
No.
Well, at one time, this was a hustling and bustling community. The mines were operating at full bore. We employed over 500 people. Had a lot of mom and pop shops. At one time, I can remember, we had like 30 bar rooms in this community. Everybody in town was living the American dream. They were making good wages. And then one day, excuse me, supervisor's office. What? The store was robbed? No kidding. She robbed the till? Jeez, that doesn't surprise me. We all know she was hurting for money after the surgery. I know, it was the biggest damn mole I've ever seen, too. All right then, get a hold of Sheriff. I'll be right there.
Goodbye.
Well, I'm gonna have to go. I got some business I have to attend to. You're welcome to come along.
She's gone missing.
Who's running the store?
Don't really know. We showed up our usual time. Place is empty, door was open, so we come on in for a bit.
So when's the last time you seen her?
Last time we seen Earlene, she was walking down by the lake. Yep, she come down there to see old useless ass Bob.
Hell, she ain't gonna find Bob down by the lake.
If she wants to find Bob, he's not going to the lake. Bob's probably out tending that marijuana plant of his at his warehouse there.
So the last time anybody seen her, you're telling me she was down by the lake? Simple question. You know, it seems to me there's been a lot of mysterious crap going on down by that lake this week.
Well, you want to know what's going on, maybe you ought to ask your out-of-towner friends here. Maybe they know.
They're here doing a documentary on Champ. They're good people, and I'm sure they'd love the opportunity to interview you gentlemen. If you can relate to a time that you saw Champ when you were sober, possibly, and I know that's going to be an impossibility, but anyway, I'm sure they'd love to talk to you.
Well, I think you'll understand if nobody's real anxious to talk on camera after
the incident and all.
All right, Jimbo, I know you went and got yourself another dog. It don't matter. I got plenty of buckshot.
You better come armed with more than buckshot. I got me an AK-47 here with two shells and your names on it.
I apologize. You were saying?
Well, as I was saying, this town was a boom town. The mines were rolling, stores were full, people was living the American dream. Then some folks come in here and said they was gonna make this feature film, bring us all up. Well, said it was big. Had Paul Sorvino in it even.
Paul Sorvino, he was in The Godfather.
Wasn't he in American Graffiti?
That ain't no Italian mob movie. He was a black guy with a big porn.
If you two don't shut up, I swear I'm gonna lose what little mind I got left. Anyway, as I was saying, they come to town and gonna make this movie. We all got behind them. People pitched in. And of course, it tanked.
Mineville. That was so offensive. leaves a bad taste in my mouth every time I say the word Mineville.
That movie was so bad, Malcolm blew his face off over that crap.
We ain't never had no friend named Malcolm.
Dang Nabbit Scooter.
Who are you thinking of?
Dang Nabbit Scooter, shut up. Well, anyway, long story short, I don't reckon you're gonna find too many folks around here gonna wanna talk to you about no movie.
I'd head down to the harbor and find Rex, if you can find him.
Any of y'all know where we might locate this here Rex fella?
Well, I gotta get heading out of here. Why don't you just jump in with me? We'll go down to the harbor and I'll drop you off. Maybe we'll find him down there.
Dogs? Rex don't need dogs. He's a mountain man. Why, there was this one time he wrestled a grizzly with his bare hands. You know, Rex, he come back with a few cuts and scrapes, of course, but that bear was never the same. He nearly frightened it to death. Well, this is about as far as I can go. You keep on heading towards that open fields and you're bound to eventually run into Rex, if and he don't see you first.
Good luck.
Dropped off in the middle of nowhere. Got a goddamn headache. Not one usable interview. This guy turns out to be another freaking hillbilly. I'm out of here. I'm serious, I'm done.
You all lost or something?
Are you Rex?
Rex who?
Mountain Man Rex.
Maybe. Maybe not. All depends who wants to know.
Thanks for wasting my time. I had about enough of this shit.
Hey, boss lady, should we mention the $100 reward for the best champ story?
Champ? You mean champ?
Yeah.
Well, why the hell didn't you say so? Sit your asses right down there and I'll tell you a story about what happened to me.
All right.
Okay. Now listen up, because I'm only going to tell you this once, and then you can just drag your asses out of here. I think it was back in 1982. Well, probably before you were born. Well, most of you. I had me a girl across the lake, Stanley Squiggins' daughter. And I was pretty tight with her. So it was getting dark, I had my chores all done. I figured, good chance to go see her. So I went down across, jumped in Dad's boat, started rowing across the lake. I got out there pretty good. Wind picked up, got dark as hell, storm kind of blew in, it was just freaky. I looked and I thought I see something, but I wasn't too sure. So maybe it's just my imagination. Rode a little more. I looked and the head kind of parted the water and come up out. Gee Christ, I thought I was seeing things. Then I see the water behind it. Oops. I said to myself, what the hell? And then it disappeared. Started rolling some more. I'm a little more excited now. Looking around, rolling. All of a sudden, bang! Right out. Just about knocked me out of the boat. Or went in. I reached down. I did reach down. Grabbed the oar. That's when that son of a bitch grabbed me right by the arm and flopped me right around and banged me against the boat. Next thing I know, I was in the air, flying, landed, went to start swimming, didn't have one arm. What, you think I'm shitting you? You think I got all these scars and shit from the operations? For nothing? I made it. Good thing old Stanley Squiggins was out there catfishing, because he see me flopping around out there. He dragged my ass up on shore. I come to. Well, at least that's the way I remember it.
Wow.
Now drag your asses, give me the money.
Lock that in your cash or check?
Cash.
There you go, sir.
See ya.
All right.
It could be fun. We could see the nice, beautiful Adirondack Mountains.
You know what, Joel? We're not going for a drive because you don't have a car.
No, I do have a car. It's just, it's how you say, it's in the shop right now. It is only a temporary situation, Rachel. Where are you going? What?
Y'all know what you want.
Oh, hello. Yes, we will both have your finest cut of beef smothered in bechamel sauce with baby arugula.
So what you're saying is you want a couple of cheeseburgers with lettuce and tomato on the side.
I see you are very perceptive and voluptuous. May I inquire as to your availability?
Are you trying to pick me up?
Well, we could take a bus to my mother's house. I have a pull-up. It's only a temporary situation. You see, my house is on.
Can we just get the check? Two boxes to go, please. We have to head over to Fred's.
Oh, my goodness. This is so embarrassing. Larry, I think I left my wallet back at the cabin. You wouldn't happen to have any money on you. I will pay you back, I promise.
Shut up, Joel.
As soon as my mother gets her government check, I will pay you back. I swear, thank you. This means a lot to me. And thank you, it was nice to meet you. Oh. Wait, Larry, come back. She means nothing to me, I promise.
Oi, Fred! Fred!
Get off my land!
I'm looking for Fred!
What are you doing down there?
We're doing a film about the Lake Champlain.
A what?
The monster in your lake.
What?
The monster in your lake.
Who?
Are you Fred?
Get off my land!
No, Fred, I wanted to see if I could talk to you about the monster in your lake. Your neighbor said you might have some information.
What for?
It's a film crew. We're here working on a documentary about the Lake Champlain monster.
The Lake Monster? I don't know what that is.
We want to talk to you about the monster that lives in your lake.
Oh, the monster in the lake? I've been telling people about it for years. Nobody listens. I call the sheriff, he don't come around. I tell you, I know how that monster got in there. It was the goddamn government. They put it in there, get after my cows. It came up one night, my biggest cow.
Wait, hold on. Do you mean to tell me that you've actually seen the monster and it ate one of your cows?
Cows? I ain't got no cows. You see any cows around here, fool?
You just said that you saw the monster eat one of your cows.
Man, I used to work for the CIA. I know they put that monster in there. It's goddamn government is what it is. I know the Lake Champlain monster exists, so I got my buddy Fred's hand right here. I seen it eat his hand right off the boat. His oar broke and a bang.
Well, that's what we wanted to talk to you about. You just...
Hey, don't you walk away. I tell you things you don't want to know. The government's watching. They're everywhere. Don't look up. The satellites will get your face and then they track you. Don't use Facebook. And it's all about the goddamn money. Get back there. I got things to tell you. The government did it. Oh, no. Rats. I lost his hand. Rats.
Knock it off!
Gosh, you're such a baby. You should come in. There's all kinds of crazy stuff down here.
On the bottom of a lake, really?
Oh, there's like an old boat. It looks like it's wrecked.
A wrecked boat on the bottom of the lake? You're telling me lies.
I can get some great photos for your next album, though.
That's nice. You do that. Wake me up when you're finished playing mermaid. Diana!
Hey, this ain't
see. Come back.
All right, now settle down. Just tell me what the problem is.
Sheriff, we got a dead body washed up off the side of the lake.
Dead body?
Well, whose body is it, Skippy?
I can't tell you who it is because he ain't got no freaking face.
What do you mean he has no face?
Everybody's got a face.
No, I mean it looks like something gone bit it clean off.
Jesus particular Christ, are you telling me we got another murder on our hands?
What we got here is a worm-filled, nameless, faceless, freako freaking nature here.
Now how in the hell is that supposed to help me, Skippy?
Throw me a freaking bone now, would you?
Hold on, let me check. I think I might have found something here, Sheriff.
This man has what appears to be a third nipple
down on his stomach.
Every other man and woman and child in this county has got a
third nipple. Check his feet. What kind of shoes is he wearing?
Well, mystery solved. This guy be Bob. Bob lost his toe in a boating accident.
And this man's missing a pinky toe on his left foot.
What about his teeth, Skippy? Did you think to check his pearly whites?
Well, that idea might have been fine and dandy, Sheriff, if it wasn't for the fact that this man wore dentures, and they're scattered a mile and a half up the road. Oh, and did I mention he ain't got no frickin' face?
God damn it.
A local family has reported their daughters missing. According to eyewitnesses, Diana and Juliet Sauté were last seen on Sunday afternoon, swimming and diving in the waters off.
Guys, listen to this!
My girls are both experienced swimmers and always kept a close eye out for each other. There's just been too many accidents happening down by the lake. Perhaps we should take a closer look at these crew up here doing the documentary about the lake monster.
Local residents are up in arms. Let's listen in.
Government, IRS sent them in here to mess with our minds, to screw up the way we think.
Well, all right, I'm out of here.
Oh, yeah. I agree. I think we should get out of here before the lynch mob of three-eyed, web-toed, freaking six-fingered freaks of nature, FBI, okay, I married my own grandpa because I, you know, cut off my schnoz and try to use this long biking.
Don't!
What?
Let's go!
Did you see these, please?
Good morning. It's Tommy.
Who's that you say?
Tommy? Tommy who?
Tommy.
Town supervisor.
No, this isn't the supervisor's office. You got the wrong number. Call down here at the store.
Some fella, he is looking for you. He got me. He must have dialed the wrong number.
Well, that's mighty kind of you, Erlene, to call and let me know this. Listen.
Well, I got you on the phone. I need a favor.
Why, of course, Tommy. You need me to extend you some store credit?
No, I don't need any store credit, Erlene.
What I do need for you to do is get on that CB of yours, and I want you to get in touch
with Rex and the rest of the gang.
Ooh, Green Doggy, you got a poker game in mind for tonight?
No, we don't have any poker
game in mind, Erlene. We wouldn't dare have one without you there. You've been drinking? Good girl. Okay, listen, we got a situation brewing right now. Not that kind of brew. As you know, them city slickers are in town.
Trying to make a documentary on Champ.
Yeah.
And I just sent my cousin, Officer Orlo, down there to head him off at the pass before they leave town. So I'm going to send him down your way.
Okay.
They owe you money? Well, listen, it's time that we put this charade to bed. We've carried this on a little bit too long.
Yeah, I agree. It's gone on too far.
So I'm going to go home, get out of this shirt and tie, and I'll be down there in a few. So, okay, you listen, stay sober. Goodbye.
Okay, well, we'll see you when you get here then. Okay, Tommy. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Suspects in route to your location, over.
I don't know where we're going.
Who the bloody hell is?
Oh, it's parked in the middle of the road. I can't bloody take this anymore. It's driving.
Stop when I tell you to stop.
I think y'all know why we're here.
Excuse me, one second. Boss lady, you wouldn't happen to have any cash on you or change or anything? I seem to hold the store a little bit. Credit card, cash, anything?
Store owner! You see any store owner around here? Do you see any store? This place doesn't even exist! It ain't on the map!
You wanna play rough? Come on, say hello to my little friend. Come on, bring it to me. I'm still standing here.
Hey.
You so sound like De Niro in that Godfellas movie.
Shut up! Calm down, little fella. We're just here to give you back your reward money. So don't have a nervous breakdown. Nervous breakdown? I can tell you a thing or two about nervous breakdowns, because I've had a few. The government keeps putting things in my water, making great crazy things!
Knock it off, Fred.
I'm gonna send Rex up there to kick your ass.
Rex! There ain't no Rex! He got blown up in the war, I see it! I got a piece of his hand right here! He blew up over in Nam, I seen him in the rice bed, he go, boom! There's little pieces everywhere! I'll hold on to him, I'll bring him everywhere I go. I'll keep him right here in my pocket. Rex. Look it. Here, that's your money back.
Wait a minute, I'm confused. You won, though. You had the best story about the lake monster.
You mean the story about Champ? Well, he don't really exist. Champ! Champ exists! He's out in the lake right now! I know it! The government put him there to keep an eye on old Fred! They're always watching Fred! They don't leave me alone. They're always in my TVs and in my microwaves putting microphones in the wall. I don't know why they do it. They just won't leave Fred alone!
Pay no attention to him. We're not proud of what we've done here.
So what you're saying is...
So what I'm saying is, they're all liars! These zombie wannabes are gonna feed you the lake monster! Get out of here! Get off my land! But don't go anywhere, I want to talk to you. So lonely.
What I was asking is if we pay up at the store, we're good to go. We can get out of here.
Go! Go where? You're in the middle of nowhere! There's nowhere to go! You might as
might as well jump in the lake and go swimming with me and Champ!
Yeah!
But the bottom line is,
get off my land!
We depend on tourism dollars to help our local economy. And in fact, today happens to be Champ Day, and if we get up there so we don't miss it, we'll get to see the parade, you'll get to do a few interviews. I personally believe that there is something out there. I've seen it myself. Might have had a cocktail or two in me, but I have seen Champ. So follow me and we'll go up to the parade.
Signs out here saying that all these people have seen this monster at some point. I've been flagging people down for hours. I don't know what Mom and Mallory are doing. I think they're just farting around back at the cabin. I don't know why they sent me out here. I didn't know why it's my responsibility. I'm the goddamn cinematographer. You know, you think that Mallory would be out interviewing people. But anyway, I've been out here just trying to get an interview with anybody. Anyone that'll talk to me. It's bloody hot out here, and I can't stay. I'm not going to stay out here for much longer. It's been raining, and then it's been sunny. It's bipolar. The weather is completely bipolar. I can't stand it. I'm baking right now. I don't know if you can see the sun on my face. It's hot as hell. I'm burning. I'm going to be sunburned. I've got feverish skin, and I don't know why this is my responsibility. So anyway, might have a person? No. Just another person driving by thinking, goddamn tourists in my town. Must not be my town, must slow down and look at it. I don't want to offend anybody in the community, but these people are liars. They haven't actually seen the monster. You'll notice that these reports all happened on Fridays and Saturdays. That's a fact. Look these dates up. This was a Friday.
All that quarters on the land make me nervous. Ever since the aliens took over the post office, what I left in all the envelopes made me like a shot. Give me postal traumatic stress disorder. Get up here, Champ. You and me need to talk. Not like last time.
Yeah, you come. That's what I thought.
You bitch right now.
My name is Joel Plue, and I'm co-producing, co-directing, and co-wrote the story for Champosauras. Working with my mom, Lori Kelly, on the project, and we're shooting up here in Essex County, New York. Champosauras is a project about a group of documentary filmmakers that are trying to prove or disprove the myth of the Lake Champlain Monster.
What are your responsibilities?
Right, and producing, directing, managing the DP, who, son of a bitch, he's miserable. We fight day and night. I pick out a scene, he fights me all the way. It can go on for hours, especially if he has a drink, then it's really miserable.
So now you want to come much closer with that mic? You won't see it. He's going to check you. So you're going to come in with the mic, and he's going to...
His flight cost $600, and that was the whole budget for him, so he's pretty fucked.
You can come in a lot closer than that. Just keep bringing it in until she tells you you're hit. Can bring it down.
One awesome thing, at least what I like, is that I'm playing multiple characters in this movie, which is pretty cool.
You're not getting any. Keep coming. You're on a 50mm lens.
I was also going to play the sheriff until this Corey came on board, and he just started like fighting with me about it. He's like, you can't play the sheriff. You look like a 10-year-old dressed up in a costume. I was like, yeah, well, I'm good anyway. I'm not now, though, for some reason. So, yeah.
My name's Corey.
Give me that. You're making all kinds of noise with it.
All right.
You're killing my shot.
I'm shooting the film. I'm excited about it. I flew all the way from Los Angeles. I brought with me a whole bunch of gear.
And we're using these really awesome GoPro cameras. So the underwater shots are going to be pretty cool. I don't know. I'm not a techie person, so.
Between the three of us, we're hoping to be able to capture a solid picture with a nice image that presents a believable story to the audience that they can follow along.
Honestly, anything, if anything's going to go bad, it's going to be Champ comes out of the water and eats us all, or we get rained out. So it's either going to be God or Champ.
Tan me hide when I'm dead, Fred. Tan me hide when I'm dead. So we tanned his hide when he died, Clyde, and that's it hanging on the shed all together now. Tie me kangaroo down, sport. Tie me kangaroo down. Tie me kangaroo down, sport. Tie me kangaroo down.